Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. There are occasionally circumstances where it's difficult to find the right wood for a friction fire, bow drill, say. I'm going to show you something today that might be one solution to broaden your choices of what to use for friction fire. Let's get started. Okay. Now, there's situations where perhaps there's a lot of knots in a wood. There's a lot of, perhaps you only have a short section of a branch that's available to use, and then it widens out into a Y, branches out. You're limited as to what you can use for hearth and for your spindle for friction fire. Now, here in Alaska, south central Alaska, even during the rainiest times, your water, what you want to find is a dead standing tree. That's what you want to use for friction fire. Now, the water will soak in about a maximum of an eighth of an inch, typically, even during the rainiest times. When you saw a log apart, you'll see, you know, where it's wet and it comes in about an eighth of an inch. You want your best wood, your driest wood, is typically right in the center of your choice of wood that you're using. That's typically the best wood to use for your spindle and your hearth. Now I'm gonna, let's just say we only have a short length here available. We're gonna use that for our spindle, which we've already got made up. And so where are we gonna get our hearth? What we're going to do is we're going to saw off a little disc off of the end. We're going to use the end as our hearth, and I'll show you how we do that. Okay, we've got our disc cut off, about standard hearth thickness here. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to break off a section of it. To where it'll place our divot, our hole, out in close to the middle. Okay, I don't want to be too abusive with this so that it messes it up. Now you just go ahead and burn in like a standard hearth. So, we'll go ahead and make this burn in, and then we'll be back. Okay, we've got our hole burn in now. We've got our notch cut, just like a standard a hearth board. Now this is totally different in that you're working with the end grain rather than the side grain, but it works very well, if not better than the side grain. So let's go ahead and get an ember. Mm-hmm. Okay, we've got smoke. We're just gonna work here for a while and build up the hot dust. Okay, that looks pretty good in there. Now, if you do it properly, friction fire isn't difficult. It's not a lot of work. I see people just wearing themselves to a frazzle trying to get an ember, and it's not that difficult. Okay, I'm letting this ember sit for a while, letting it kind of coagulate, solidify. If you wait for a while like that, it usually holds together better and doesn't want to break up as easy. There, we've got a good transfer here. Now I'll just let it sit here for a bit and warm up its new home. Okay. There we go. Hopefully that'll give you another idea. Chances are you'll never need this, but it's just one more piece of knowledge in your arsenal in case you ever do run onto a situation where you just haven't got the available wood to make a long hearth board. This is a viable alternative. I learned about this using the end grain from David West. Check out his channel. He is a friction fire guru. David West channel. I'll give you a link right here. We'll see you on the next video. You guys take care.